Hello, it's good to be with you today. How are you doing? My body's feeling kind of tired, but I'm really thankful for the sunshine and the green trees that I can see out my window. Those things make me feel really happy. How are you feeling in your body today? What are some of the things that make you feel happy today? That sounds amazing. I love thinking of things that make me feel happy. When I think of those things, I start to feel happier and happier. So today we have a really special activity. We are going to make a happiness container. It's like a treasure box that you put treasures into that make you feel happy. You know how sometimes when you're feeling sad or angry, it can be hard to think about the things that make you feel happy. This happens to me all the time. So the cool thing about this happiness treasure box is that every time we open it and look inside, we remember the things that make us feel happy. So I'm going to tell you today how to make a happiness treasure box, and it starts with a scavenger hunt because you need some supplies to make this. So the things you need are a container that will be your treasure box. So it could be a shoe box or a box like this. This one's a big one. Or it could be a small box. This one's kind of small. It could be a jar that's empty that you found at home. If you think that you might want to put a lot of special things from your house or your room into your box, choose something big so there's space to put things. If you think you might want to write things on paper that make you happy, you can choose something small. Whatever you choose should be something that makes you feel happy. If it's a shoebox like this that you maybe like don't love some parts of it, that's okay. We're gonna do some decorating so you can make it look exactly how you want. If you find the perfect box to use in your room, but it already has something in it, try to find a new place for those things that are already in it. And if you're going around your house and you find something that already has stuff in it, talk to an adult at home who can help you find a new spot for the stuff inside so that you can have a wonderful treasure box. Okay, so in addition to a container that will be your happiness treasure box, you'll also need some art supplies. So you might want some paper to decorate your box. Mine is right over here. Colored paper, white paper, construction paper. You can even use notebook paper. And some drawing materials. Markers, crayons. I've got some paint sticks, maybe some colored pencils. You while you go gather your supplies, and I'll be here when you get back. You might want to pause the video so you can go and get everything, and I'll be right here. Okay, welcome back. I see you've got a container for your treasure box and some art supplies, so that's great. I'm excited to see what you're gonna make. We are going to start by decorating our treasure box. I have decided to use this large shoe box. And I'm going to decorate it with some paper and other art materials I have. So you get to decorate your box, and I'll be here decorating with you. And afterwards, I'll tell you how to go on a big treasure hunt to find all the things that will go in your box. I'm going to play some music that makes me happy while we're decorating. If you need more time than I use to decorate, you can always pause the video and play it again when you're finished decorating. Okay, I'm gonna play some music. Have fun decorating. Thank you. I've made a heart that I'm going to cut out and glue into my box because this is an image that makes me feel happy. I encourage you to use whatever colors or materials like paint or crayons that make you feel happy. You can even put words on it, like your name or words of things that make you feel happy. Looking good, friends. You're working hard in your treasure box. Excited to see how it turns out. Thank you. undecorate. I'm starting to glue on some of these hearts that I've made. Put it right here so you can see what I'm doing. On the top of my turn now. Got some hearts. Make me happy. Okay, friends, if you need more time to decorate your box, go ahead and pause the video. We are going to move on to the treasure hunt. Okay, are you ready to fill your treasure box with special things that make you feel happy? Awesome, me too. Let's get started. So the first thing that we're going to do is get some pieces of paper ready so that we can draw on our pieces of paper and write things. I have some note cards like this, but if you don't have that, you can use a piece of construction paper, a piece of regular paper, and we're just going to cut these into squares or rectangles. Like this. It's easy to make them into little pieces of paper that we can write on and put into our treasure box. Okay, got a bunch of pieces of purple paper and I've got some pieces of white paper. So the first thing that we're going to do is put a butterfly into our treasure box. So we're going to make a butterfly on a card. This is mine. You can draw a butterfly too. Yours will look different than mine, but it'll also be beautiful. So go ahead and work on your butterfly. Can I see your butterfly? That looks great. Okay, so before we put our butterfly card into our treasure box, let me get mine right here. We are going to do a butterfly hug. So, put your hands out in front of you like this. Now flip them around. Make sure your thumbs are hooked. We're going to put our hands right here on our chest, and we're going to tap our hands back and forth very slowly. So take a deep breath and follow me. We'll move our butterfly wings one at a time. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Take a deep breath and let it go. Very good, you just did a butterfly hug. So notice the feelings in your body. Are you noticing any good sensations?
That's great. Okay, keep letting your butterfly hug you and we'll do a few more
taps.
One, two, one, two. One, two, one, two. Take a deep breath in and let it go.
Good job, friends.
Now I want you to think about one person that makes you happy.
Can picture that person's face in your mind. If it helps, you can close your eyes. So imagine their face.
What are they doing? Are they looking at you? Are they smiling at you? How does that make you feel? Where do you feel those happiness feelings in your body? Yeah, just let yourself enjoy that good feeling for a moment.
Now, draw something on your card that will remind you of that person. Maybe it's the person's name, maybe it's a picture.
Okay,
so you've got it. Let's put it in our treasure box. Mine's in there. And let's put our butterfly in our treasure box too. This is something that we can use anytime we want to feel happy. Okay. Are there any other people that make you feel happy and loved and safe?
If so, do the same thing again. Write another name on your paper or
draw a picture. Maybe you even have some photos of the people you love. I have some photos here, and I'm going to put these in my happiness box so I can think about those people that make me happy anytime I'm feeling sad.
Now, can you think of your favorite memory? Sometimes that's a hard one, so if you can't think of a favorite memory, that's okay.
But if a memory comes to mind, favorite memory or something happy that happened recently, I want you to go around your house and find something that reminds you of it. Maybe it's a seashell or a drawing you did in a notebook. If you can't find anything around your house, you can draw something on one of your pieces of paper. So I'm going to go ahead and draw my memory while you are working on yours.
Looks like you've got something for your favorite memory. Let's go ahead and add it to the box.
Okay, now we're going to think of some things that make our body happy. Can you think of your favorite food? Can you imagine tasting it and smelling it and eating it?
What does that feel like?
Draw your favorite food on one of your cards. And we'll put it in the box. You could also find something around the house that tastes good, like gum or candy. I have some mints. These taste like green tea. And green tea is one of my favorite things to drink, so these mints are very delicious. Just make sure that if you find something from around your house, it's not going to go bad in your box. So you don't want something like fruit or a cupcake. Something like mints or gum. Okay, let's put our favorite food in our box. Now, can you think of something that smells really good? Maybe you have a favorite smell. Imagine smelling it. What does that feel like? So, I have some Play-Doh that smells like lavender. Lavender is one of my favorite smells because it's really relaxing. Don't have something around your house like a perfume or a lotion that smells really good to you. You could draw something on your paper that reminds you of it. So I'm going to go ahead and draw a picture of lavender on here.
So draw your favorite smell.
Maybe it's freshly baked cookies or a certain perfume.
I'm also going to draw a picture of some rain because I think when it rains, the earth and the sidewalk smells so good. It's one of my favorite smells.
we're feeling sad or angry, we can think of our favorite smell. Take a deep breath in and out, and it can help us feel more calm and more happy. Okay, so once you have your favorite smells, let's put them in our box. All right, next up. What about your favorite thing to look at? One of my favorite things to look at are really pretty rocks with pretty colors. Can you see this one? Yeah. Makes me feel calm and happy to look at it and see the different shapes and shines. What's your favorite thing to look at? You can find something from your house, or you can draw it on a piece of paper. Maybe you have some pictures or a special toy or a pretty object. Can you go get that? And we'll put it in your box. Okay, once you have your drawing or your favorite special thing to look at, let's put those in the box. Now, can you think of your favorite thing to touch? I really love to touch soft things, like soft blankets and stuffed animals, because they make me feel comforted. What's your favorite thing to touch? Okay, draw that on a card, or go look around your house for something that fits. It's small enough that can fit in your box. So I can't fit a whole blanket in my box, but I do have a soft stuffed animal that's so fuzzy. I really like feeling the stuffed animal when I'm sad. So I'm going to put it in my box. Great, friends. You are doing such a good job filling your happiness treasure box with things that make you happy. Now we're going to make 5 activity cards that can be things you can do when you're feeling sad. So in addition to feeling your soft toys, looking at pictures that make you feel happy, we're gonna have some activities. So the first one is think of 5 things you are thankful for. So I'm gonna hold this up so that you can write it on your card in case you're not quite sure how to spell some of these words. So when you're thinking of things that you're thankful for, it could be just about anything. It could be a delicious snack you had earlier. It could be a hug from someone you love. It could be your favorite TV show, your favorite teacher, really anything. Okay, so this is our first one. I'm gonna put them in a pile, and then at the end, we'll put them in our box. The next activity is to smile at 4 people. When we smile, it helps us feel a little bit happier, even if we're sad or mad or angry. I'm smiling right now and I feel even a little bit happier than before. Okay, putting that in our stack. Next, do 3 dance moves. This one sounds fun. I think if I was feeling angry, this is the activity I'd want to do. Dancing all around, trying different moves, and getting out some of my angry energy. I'd probably laugh a little bit because dancing is fun and sometimes silly. Okay. Our next activity is name 2 people you love. When you name these 2 people, you might think about how they're able to support you, and if maybe you would be able to talk to them about feeling sad or mad. Maybe if they're far away from you, you could call them on the phone, send them a text message, or write them a letter. Or draw them a picture that you show them next time you see them. If they're in your house, you could go talk to them. You could give them a hug. And our last activity is do 1 kind thing for someone. Sometimes when we're sad or mad,
It helps us feel happier if we do something nice for someone else. Maybe you could make a snack for a sibling or do a chore that helps your parents out. Maybe you could draw a picture to give to someone to brighten their day. Be creative. You'll know what to do. Okay.
So, these are activities that we're going to be able to put in our box. And when we're feeling sad, we might try doing some of these.
So here's my box. I'm going to show you what my box looks like now. I've got all these things in here to help me when I'm feeling sad. Remember that whenever you're feeling hard emotions, you can open up your box and look through it. Make sure you keep it in a special place where you can get to it easily. Great work, friends.